Yeah, a spontaneous occasion the other night at Cara Vida's. Loren sat down on the piano and I picked up a guitar, and I had never played with him before in my life. And we just took off.
Yeah.
And then right in the middle of it, I heard a voice. And that was Dave, and he was just spontaneously throwing some words into the whole mix. Mm-hmm. I like it when that happens. I want to mention one more thing. Back in the mid-70s, I was some kind of a college student for a while, and I was going to an open mic on Fillmore called Minnie's Can Do Bar.
Oh, yeah.
And the person running the show was Ruth Weiss, who is sitting right over here. Her hair was a different color back then, but otherwise, nothing has changed. And I appreciated, you know, working with her at that place. Plus, she introduced me to Carol Dodo. That's Dodo. Dodo? Yeah. Anyway, that's another story. This is called Free Words. Spoken word and self-promotion. There is a sound wave locomotion with the local yokels vocalizing. Words are volatile, they are connected to the brain, a neurological refrain. It hits you like a lightning bolt, it's in your blood and a revolt is running you. It's hot and cold inside my head, a sense of dread connected to an empty bed. Demented though, as if he meant it, those sidewalks have cemented my relationship to city living. The audacity of everybody's audio. The poets saying adios until they're black and blue in the face. A nervous nerve in outer space. And that's where everybody lives, and I believe that it forgives our sins. It is a scintillating universe, a vacillating destiny inherited by virtue of unmerited arrival through the vaginal. Your ego is imaginal. Your magic subjectivity can generate activity it takes a lifetime to resolve. I am evolving into something else, and some of us are singing in the graveyard. It is bringing it all back home because you live in your lungs. It gives you breathing room and airing brainwaves, I assume. And if the oxygen is making you an airhead, and you're taking liberties and think you should be getting royalties, I wouldn't disagree. Refine your voice, your sins forgiven by the void. You're trashy and delusional, the dizziness as usual. The sound effects are kind of cruel. The human body is a tool. It's tuning up the intuition as you walk into the ocean or an uninhibited lake with your libido on the make. It takes a certain attitude. We're looking for some latitude according to the laws of matter and the purple light inside the ice of wine. Smoothest ride in town, and all the intonations of complete communication when the poets get together, and the literary weather can be dry, or is it stormy, with my reason, and the normal folks are hit by winds and lightning bolts, and if they want to lighten up, they smoke a little weed and later get back to the world, feeling like they somersaulted with a joint. It's not their fault if there are signals in the air, an existential laissez-faire. Who needs a two-dimensional tension when you have a fourth dimension for expanding your persona? It's filling up the phone. But maybe it's unrealistic. Living in a long linguistic dream, an old preoccupation. Could have had an occupation, but instead you were diverted by the voices and the words inside your head. A time-consuming way of being where you're zooming in on the remote. I'm living by remote control. It's giving me an air of being not all there. And then I hear the call of nature. The definition is a warp, a human heat wave on 2 feet, a four-dimensional transparency. It's more than I can hold a candle to, and there are times that I can't handle it. Others have it worse, incapable of writing verse. Their lives are such a bump in the grind, the turbulence inside the mind, like riding on a minibus, and every sentence is a bust. The meanings are illegible, and so you're getting kind of edgy, your mentality defected, your dimension disconnected. Lost in space, I feel more grounded with the woman. I'm lost and found inside of her, a twilight zone of estrogen. It sets the tone for all of those misunderstandings, but you come in for a landing with a woman, and the earth is moving. Maybe it isn't worth it seeing your autonomy eclipsed by her anatomy. But life is like a woman bending over and I know the ending.
It's been great, y'all. And they were keeping it in New Orleans. And Stephen and Sarah and myself will be editing that magazine, The Celebration of Households. We'll bring it out right about the solstice. And of course, they have Out of Our magazine, which I think you can pick up at the Bee Museum or wherever around here. And our Celebration of Households, you'll definitely be able to get it here. City Lights as well. And we're going to have a very special poet come up, and then we have something else special right behind that. And then we're going to enjoy the beautiful sounds of Loren and Lucas, and also Hal has brought the beautiful log from Albion, California. We'll be joining them up here. Please help me welcome to the stage very, very terrific, wonderful spirit, soul shine of poetry. All of you know her, and if you don't, you are about to. You heard her a little bit earlier. Please help me welcome to the stage poet Julie Rogers.
So I'm going to do some short little poems that I've done before with some sax. That was pretty fun. This first one is called Bearing Fruit. Her yearning to be fruitful was so great, she could ripen in seconds. Pink-cheeked and full-buttocked with the glow of a peach and a taste as sweet as the real thing. She admitted longing for shapes, seduced by pears, their firm figures lounging in a full bowl beside the bananas, arching their backs and spooning the oranges, so juicy. Strawberries pursed as lips, pressed by grapes piled deep in their perfect skins. Her passion to run them through her hair, almost too much for a girl to bear. After those other poems, you never know. Mining. Digging beneath the ideas, not one can truly understand who I am. Human, woman, aging, raging to know, wild to love, imploding with the world, exploding with expression, trapped in the fast car of wanting. Resisting the pull of predictable loss, strung up by hope, tangled by fear, swollen with desire, but ignoring it as required, twitching without control and waiting to let go. Oh, holy guru, help. help me let go. The pickaxe ritual of life is always trying to climb out of the mine that will never rest. And under the raw earth and the old bones and the fossils, beneath history and philosophy, and prophecy, beyond thought, what's left? For example, her karma is all in her head. Wherever she goes, it follows, dog on the leash of her tongue. Karma walks her to the corner in town with a red dress on. Karma sets her up in an apartment. Karma is the rent, always due. She comes back every night, cooks Karma dinner, that demanding tyrant refusing to clean up. Karma follows her to the mirror. She can't distinguish between them, their wrinkles identical. And when she dies, Karma will hold her like a promise. This is for my friend Katie Heflin, who is a local. She's been into your bar.
Right on.
Yeah. She's there right now. This is called Life Work. There is something so precious. Its impossible star streaks across your life. A pilgrimage to the secret of why you keep on living, picking up the mail, shuffling papers, paying over and over for hope to be who you must be, or why suffer? You ask yourself, could it happen? Yes. No. Yes. Its delicious, familiar taste rolls on your tongue with the name your mother called you by. And as you swallow this, someone finally, absolutely born, bursts forth like a new planet, where you now walk with your head held up, knowing you can do your work. And it is good. This is written in Cafe International on Haight, where I like to hang out. And they have a really nice little jazz band that plays in there on Sunday nights. So I was in there, and this is what happened. It's called Jazz Bar. Trumpet finger pad tap dance. Slow steps won't fall off the gleaming brass twist of pipe. An abstract tubular wrap of sounds. Some wild bow on surprise jazz. Sunday night. International Cafe Roost Mix. Single set, bass nudging forward feet to dance. Cymbals sizzling low coals under guitar's sleek slide. Down keyboard smooth groove, with trombone slippery moan into wide open sax. Wailing sweet, not to mention that bubbling flute. Comfort. Stop wanting. Take your mouth off your mind. The tasting has made you crazy. Back off real smooth. Back off without trying. It's just the next moment now. Notice your surroundings. the weight of your hands, the quiet sound of breathing, your chest rising regular as wind. The body lets down windows for the calm to come in. The wafting silent bell of your heart alive in there on its own. It doesn't worry, and neither should you. Sooner or later,